Welcome to JSA TV, the newsroom for tech and telecom professionals. I'm Jamie Scott-Akataya of JSA, here at Telecom Exchange LA in Beverly Hills. Joining me, my good friend, Mr. Todd Coleman. He is the president and CEO of eStructure. Todd, welcome to JSA TV.
Jamie, thanks as always for having me. Pleasure to be here.
You are one of our top industry thought leaders, speakers. It's a pleasure and honor to have you here. And you've got more news every day, every time I talk to you. Tons of news coming out. You've obviously expanded your company out of Montreal and westward to Vancouver this year, notably. How has this experience been serving these two unique markets?
Yeah, I mean, it's been interesting. You know, I've, in prior businesses, I've worked in around Vancouver, so it's not foreign to me, as I like to describe it. I mean, Vancouver is a challenging market. The real estate prices are through the roof. It's very disaggregated from a competition perspective. All attributes that we like a whole lot, reasons why we've gone into the market. As I like to tell everyone, look, if it was easy, everyone would be there. So it requires a bit of work. And so for us, it's about knowing where it's similar and where it's dissimilar. So for us, you know, we're all about driving scale from a process perspective, engineering standards, how we operate, but then having to localize it from a customer touch and a sales perspective. And so those attributes are different. You know, we, one of the biggest reasons why we went into Vancouver is a good reason. Our customers took us westward, right? We had cloud providers and a number of carriers asking us to go west. We have a significant ecosystem in Montreal with the VFX community, the film studios doing rendering, et cetera. And so, you know, us migrating from Montreal to what's now called Hollywood North was a natural progression. And so we're currently building out that team, looking to go deeper into the market. You know, Vancouver is a smallish data center, 2.5 megawatts, sitting right in the Mount Pleasant neighborhood. But we didn't go there just to operate that facility. And so it's causing us to look deeper into the market, understand why we're there, what we're going to do, and how that's either the same or slightly nuanced from what we're doing in Montreal. But we're finding that the markets are more similar than dissimilar, but still keeping that local touch and that local knowledge.
And what new trends are you seeing in Montreal and Vancouver that's really driving the way you are serving your verticals?
Yeah, look, the trends are playing out every single day for us. You know, number one trend is we're seeing greater power densification within our data centers. The types of applications and the amount of power demand is only increasing, which from our perspective is a great thing. You know, we've designed, you know, eStructure is built around high density and designing, you know, bringing in the greatest amount of power and frankly driving our cost per kW every single metric within the data center as low as possible. And so that means densification. You know, we used to laugh in a prior life. You know, what we used to consider high density was 6, 7, 8 kilowatts a rack. And now if you're not 20 plus, you know, we're working with our customers to say, how do you fill up that rack? How do you take that 42U or 48U rack and fill it up to the greatest extent possible as opposed to spreading it out, which is sort of the old school data center mentality. Right. You know, beyond that, you know, other trends, you know, we're finding, and I've spoken to you about this before, understanding the needs of our customers down to the application level is becoming more and more critical. It's no longer the philosophy that, you know, a tier three data center is a tier three data center and come in and, you know, we're going to fit your needs. We look at our customer applications to understand what do they need? What do they need from a power perspective? What do they need from a redundancy perspective? Do they even need generator backup? Do they need UPS backup? What's the level of security? And so I think that's going to progress. We're seeing that trend play out. You know, blockchain's been a big driver of that. Even the VFX community that we have within our data center ecosystem is a big proponent of understanding where they're at. They have 3-month project cycles and then they go down for a month. What does that mean from a capacity perspective? And so it requires a unique knowledge base within our customer set. And I think I see that trend continuing to evolve regardless of location, whether it's Montreal or Vancouver.
And then the OTTs, completely different beast.
Completely different beast. You know, the other, you know, fortunate or unfortunate trend within the OTTs and the hyperscalers is there's an inconsistency of requirements. You know, we're understanding where they're at and they have different needs, what level of redundancy. They got different security requirements. Some like raised floor, some don't like raised floor. It's again, working with them. And for us, I guess the underlying trend there is to keep it flexible.
Yeah.
You know, it's not a one size fits all. And the more that we can be flexible in our designs while still driving operational scaling standards is going to be important as it plays out.
Also, last time on JSA TV, when we interviewed eStructure, one of your colleagues, we talked about potentially building out a channel partner program. Any updates for us on that front?
Yeah, I mean, there's no potential. We are building out a channel partner program. I mean, look, I'm a big believer. We've all had past experiences, some positive, some negative, but we learn from those experiences. And so, you know, in a prior life, I felt like we were slow to build out a channel partner program. I'm a massive believer in putting on as many feet on the street that is are telling our story and reaching out to prospects and customers alike. And so we are absolutely building out a channel partner program where you and I are sitting here in Beverly Hills. I was in Manhattan Beach earlier today meeting with a master channel partner. And so that is in the throes. That is a massive 2019 initiative for us to dedicate our own resources internally to go develop the channel more broadly, make everyone aware of what eStructure is doing in and around Canada.
And your tough CEO question of the day. When we're looking out into 2019 and beyond, do you have any news maybe on the future expansion front that you can share with us?
Well, look, we're constantly expanding. I'm not going to give away any secrets. I mean, look, we've been acquisitive. We're going to continue to be acquisitive. Where we can find the right opportunities, it's got to meet our unique requirements. We're not looking to just buy anyone and roll anyone up, but it's got fit within our model, unique footprint, right age of equipment, technology, density, location, network providers. All those things come into play, but we continue to expect to be active in the consolidation of the marketplace. Second bit is expansion. You know, we got significant expansion already underway, and we continue to see that play out. You know, we acquired our first acquisition back in February of 2017 already, and we immediately announced a 5-megawatt expansion. It's working in a multi-tenant building, so it took a little longer to get that done, but that's actually rolled out and fully live, bringing in a massive utility expansion, cutting over to generators, new generators, new mechanical, and more than doubling the white space. We acquired the former Montreal Gazette printing building. We literally have 15 megawatts of new power showing up at the end of November. The full 30 megawatts is going to be there by the end of April, and our first pod is coming online by the end of November. So no shortage of stuff going on. You know, pretty excited about all the things that we're doing from a technology perspective. You know, it's funny, when I started this company, I used to say, hey, we're not in the technology business. We don't take technology risk. And I still believe that, because at the end of the day, we're infrastructure people. But we work with new technology, and we're working with, you know, great partners. You know, I'll give you an example. We're working with Vertiv to bring in their latest and greatest cooling technology that can do 500 kilowatts a unit. And we have literally the first of their units that are coming off the manufacturing queue and are going right to Canada into our data centers. So we're excited about that. We're working with, new floor partners, which doesn't sound overly exciting, but how you handle cabling and airflow within a 150,000 square foot data center is really, really important. And so, you know, we're excited about the partners that we work with and the new technologies that we're bringing on board with these data centers.
Well, we're excited to watch you as you are on this tier up. So, which we always knew. Todd Coleman, of course, once again, at it, eStructure. Thank you, Todd, for joining us.
Thank you for having me, as always. I appreciate it.
Oh, we love having you. And thank you, viewers, for tuning in to JSA TV. Happy networking.